Gulgul's three drawings. Hello friends, my name is Gulgul. I am 6 years old. I like to draw. These are my drawings. This is my summer season drawing. I have drawn a bright sun. I have also drawn a white ice cream van. I love ice cream. Monsoon is the rainy season. Everything is wet in monsoon. This is my monsoon drawing. I have drawn children wearing colorful raincoats. I have also drawn a rainbow. I love rainbows. Do you? This is my winter drawing. I have drawn a cute snowman. The snowman has a red scarf around its neck. I have also drawn a Christmas tree. It has ribbons, colorful balls, and shiny stars. And I have drawn gifts under the tree. I love all seasons. But winter is my favorite. Which season do you like? The burnt rotis.
We are a family of three people. Me, my mother, and my father.
My mother works hard every day. Today, she is very tired. So, she has cooked something simple. There is a bowl of dal, potato sabzi, and slightly burnt rotis on the table. She calls us for dinner.
I am hungry. I rush to the table to eat dinner. I wait to see if Daddy eats the burnt rotis.
Daddy picks one roti and smiles at my mom. He asks me how my day was at school. I watch him make small pieces of the roti. Then he eats the roti and dal with a smile. After dinner, my mother says sorry to my father for burning the rotis. And I'll never forget what he says. Honey, I love burnt rotis. When I go to kiss Daddy good night, I say, "May I ask you a question, Daddy?" He says, "Yes, you may." I ask, "Do you really like your rotis burned?" He wraps me in his arms and says, "Your mom put in a hard day at work today. She is very tired.
And besides, a little burnt roti never hurt anyone."
The rainbow kite.
Ruhan is a fun-loving boy.
He loves to go out and play every day.
He plays hide and seek, catch the ball, and cricket with his friends.
Playing in the park is fun.
He gets to meet all his friends. Ruhan also loves to fly kites. He has a rainbow kite. It is made of colorful paper. The kite has a long tail. It looks like an aeroplane. The tail sways when the kite flies. Ruhan loves his kite very much. Ruhan goes to the park with his father to fly the kite. It is a windy day. The kite sways with the wind. The kite gets stuck on a treetop. Ruhan tugs the string to free the kite. But the kite does not move.
Ruhan is sad.
Father sees that Ruhan is sad. Father thinks he can reach the kite using a ladder. He fetches a ladder and climbs up. He reaches for the kite. Suddenly, the string breaks and the kite flies away. Ruhan and his father watch the kite fly away. The kite flies over the trees, over the streets, and over the houses. Ruhan waves to the kite until he cannot see it anymore. "I think the kite is happy in the sky," says Ruhan. There's a crocodile in our pickle jar. It is dinner time. Suhani sees the rice and vegetables served on her plate. She does not like vegetables. She tells her mother she is not hungry. Her mother brings out a chocolate cake.
When Suhani sees the big cake, she jumps with joy.
She says,
"Please give me some cake."
Mother says, "First eat your food. Then you can have the cake."
Suhani begs her mother to give her a small slice.
But her mother refuses. Suhani gets angry and goes to her room. After some time, she starts feeling hungry. She feels her room spinning. She goes to the kitchen. She opens the refrigerator door. There is a pickle jar lying on the first shelf. She looks at it closely and screams,
"Help! There is a crocodile in our fridge!" Mother and father come running to the kitchen.
Father picks the jar from the fridge. He opens it and takes out a long green pickled cucumber. He shows it to Suhani. Suhani's mother says, "You did not eat your dinner. An empty stomach makes the body weak. When you feel that way, your eyes can play tricks on you." Suhani says, "I'm sorry. I promise to eat properly from today. May I have some dinner?"
Father says, "Sure, you may also have that yummy cake you missed." Adapted from the original by R.D. Knapp.
The Timid Train.
Chugbuk is a newly built train.
It is black, bright and shiny with red and white stripes. But Chugbuk is frightened of new places and things.
Chugbuk knows that cows moo and dogs bark at passing trains.
So Chugbuk wishes to stay in the shed forever. But that's not possible.
Finally, the day comes for Chugbuk's first journey. An older train tells Chugbuk to blow its horn when it feels frightened. Babu, the guard, waves the green flag. Mr. Ram, the engine driver, starts the engine. Slowly, Chugbuk moves out of the shed.
Woo! Hoots Chugbuk out of fear.
The dogs near the railway track run away, hearing the loud horn.
And the birds fly away.
Chugbuk begins to move happily. It hoots now and then. The horn drives away any cow or bull sitting on the railway track.
Then Chugbuk sees a dark tunnel. It is scared. It makes a loud woo. Mr. Ram switches on the engine headlights and says, "These will show you the way." Chugbuk feels safe. It passes through the tunnel without any fear. As it comes out of the tunnel, Chugbuk feels happy. Chugbuk is now enjoying its journey. Would you like to join Chugbuk on its next journey?
Adapted from the story, The Timid Train, written by Bharti Jagannathan, Pratham Books. The Story of Forks and Spoons. Rahul, please help me set the table. Mummy calls out from the kitchen. Rahul has to set up the spoons, forks and knives on the table.
But he always forgets what goes where.
Mummy, who made spoons, forks and knives? Asks Rahul.
Mummy answers, "Long, long time ago, man lived in the caves.
He used sharp stones and bones to kill animals for food.
Then he added wooden handles to them and used them as knives. Many years later, he made metal knives."
"When were spoons made?" asks Rahul.
Mummy answers, "Early man used to eat food with his hands. Later, he started using shells and hollow stones to pour and drink liquids. At times, he also used hollow bones of dead animals as scoops."
Mummy continues, "Man later added handles to these hollow stones and bones.
And they began to look like the spoons we use now.
He made metal spoons much later."
"Do you know we have different spoons and knives for different purposes?" asks Mummy.
"I know. I have seen a soup spoon and an ice cream spoon and a bread knife and a butter knife," says Rahul excitedly.
"When did man start using forks?"
he asks.
"Forks came into use much later," says Mummy thoughtfully.
"Man made forks from sticks and bones. He used sharp sticks or bones with two long pointed parts as a fork."
"I wish I was born then. I would not need to remember which side to set the knife and which side to set the fork," says Rahul with a sigh.
Mummy pats him on his back.
"I have made soup for you. Don't forget to place the soup spoon, or you will not be able to enjoy your soup," she says playfully. The Story of Peter Rabbit.
Peter, the little rabbit, lives with his mother and his three brothers. They live under a big apple tree. Mama Rabbit needs to go to the market. She asks Peter and his brothers to play close to home.
"Don't go near Mr. Roy's garden," warns Mama Rabbit.
"But there are juicy carrots and turnips in Mr. Roy's garden. We want to taste them,"
plead the little rabbits.
"No,"
says Mama Rabbit aloud.
Peter Rabbit's brothers listen to their mother and play near their house. But Peter wants to taste the juicy vegetables.
He runs to Mr. Roy's garden and slips under the wooden gate. First, he eats some huge carrots and then some tiny turnips. They taste yummy. Then, he wants to eat some lettuce. But when he reaches the lettuce patch, he spots Mr. Roy.
"Oops!"
Peter screams. Mr. Roy looks up and shouts,
"Stop, you thief!"
Peter is frightened. He runs here and there, but cannot find the way out. Peter runs as fast as he can. He loses one of his red shoes in the carrot patch. But he does not care. He runs to save his life.
Peter passes the gooseberries. His new blue jacket gets caught in the gooseberry net. He tries to free himself.
He sees Mr. Roy rushing with a stick.
Just then, he manages to slip out of his blue jacket.
He runs to the gate and slips under it. Then he runs to his home. He is happy to be back with his family.
He decides to always listen to his mother. Abridged from the tale of Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter.
How big is a foot?
Characters in the play: narrator, king, queen, minister, and carpenter. The stage is set up as a king's court. Act 1. Long, long ago, there lived a king. One day, narrator exits and king and his minister enter, thinking aloud.
"It's my dear queen's birthday. What do I gift her? She has everything. Minister."
"Yes, my lord."
"What can I gift the queen on her birthday?"
Pointing to a table kept in a corner.
"How about getting the queen something to sleep on? It could be like that table, a wooden platform with four legs, but it will also have a backrest."
"That's a good idea. I will call it a bed."
"My lord, I will call the carpenter."
Minister claps loudly. Carpenter enters. Carpenter is a short person with small feet.
"The king wants a bed made. Let me explain to you what a bed is."
Minister explains with actions what a bed is.
"Of course, my lord. How big should the bed be?"
"It should be as big as the queen."
"How big is the queen, my lord?"
The king, minister, and carpenter look puzzled. Act 2. The stage is set up as the king's bedroom. The king asks the queen to to lie down on the floor. He walks from the queen's head to her feet and then side to side. He counts his footsteps as he walks.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The bed should be 6 feet long and 3 feet wide.
Act 3. The stage is set as the king's court. The carpenter walks in with a bed that resembles a small table with a backrest.
My lord, the bed is ready.
Excitedly,
let the queen try it.
The queen enters and lies on the bed. Angrily,
this bed is too small for the queen. Send this carpenter to the prison.
The minister drags the carpenter and exits stage. Act 4. Carpenter sitting in the prison. Thinking aloud.
Why was the bed small for the queen? I made the bed according to the size given. The king measured it with his feet. And I used the same measurement with my feet.
Pauses.
But my feet are smaller than the king's feet.
Pauses.
I solved the puzzle. I can make a bed to fit the queen if I get the size of the king's feet.
Act 5. Minister enters and bows down to the king before he speaks.
My lord, the carpenter says he can make the bed to fit the queen. He just needs the measure of your foot.
Take my shoe and give it to the carpenter to use as a measure.
The minister takes the shoe and bows and leaves. Act 6. A medium-sized bed is seen in the middle of the stage. The king, queen, minister and carpenter stand around it admiring it. The carpenter used the king's shoe to make the bed. The bed is now perfect for the queen, and the king is glad. And from now on, a foot shall be the size of the king's foot. Adapted from the story, How Big is a Foot? By Rolf Miller.
Holes in a Fence. Pritam lives in a small town with his parents. He is good in his studies.
But he gets angry very easily.
He speaks rudely to his neighbors, his friends, and sometimes even his parents. No one likes Pritam when he gets angry. His parents are worried about his behavior. One day, Pritam's father calls Pritam. He gives Pritam a hammer and a bag of nails. He asks Pritam to drive a nail into the fence whenever he gets angry. Pritam gets angry with his father. But before he opens his mouth to shout, his father points to the hammer. Pritam drives his first nail into the fence with the hammer. After that, each time Pritam gets angry, he drives a nail into the fence with the hammer. At first, he enjoys it. But later, he realizes
it is tiring to drive a nail into the fence. So, Pritam decides to control his anger.
Slowly, the number of nails he drives becomes less. And finally, he stops driving nails into the fence. He learns to control his anger. Pritam's parents are very happy. Pritam's father then asks him to remove a nail from the fence every time he controls his anger.
It takes several days for Pritham to pull out the nails from the fence. After he takes out all nails, he shows the fence to his father. "What do you see there?" asks Pritham's father, pointing at the fence. "Holes in the fence," replies Pritham. "Will the fence ever look the same again?" asks father. "No, never. The fence will always have these holes in them," says Pritham. "Yes, my dear son. These nails are like the rude things you say when you get angry. Just like nails leave a hole in the fence, your rude words hurt people. So, you should learn to control your anger and always speak kindly and politely to everyone," explains father.
Yellow daffodil.
Yellow, yellow daffodil,
dancing in the sun.
Oh, yellow, yellow daffodil, you tell me spring has come.
I can hear a bluebird sing and hear a robin call.
But yellow, yellow daffodil, I love you most of all.
Come, fly a kite. Come, fly a kite and watch it sail across the sky, waving its tail.
Kite, 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 soaring high, reaching, reaching to the sky.
First you're high, then you're low.
Swooping, swirling, round you go. Kite, kite, fine and free, dancing, dancing, just for me.
John Warren.
I am a yellow helicopter.
I am a yellow helicopter sitting on the ground.
These are my rotor blades, slowly turning round.
Faster now and faster, they are spinning like a top.
Take off, turn around, touch down, stop.
Ryan Thompson.
Important rules.
Here are some rules for you and me. See how important they can be.
Always be honest, be kind and fair.
Always be good and willing to share.
These are rules we all should know.
We follow these rules wherever we go.
Smile. A smile is quite a funny thing. It wrinkles up your face. And when it's gone, you will never find its secret hiding place. But far more wonderful it is to see what smiles can do.
You smile at one, he smiles at you. And so one smile makes two.
Ginger ran away.
Hello children, meet Ginger, Maya's cat.
He lives in Maya's house. Ginger did not get dinner last night. It is morning. Maya goes to school.
Mommy goes to office.
They forget to give Ginger breakfast also.
Daddy,
do forget to feed Ginger.
Ginger is feeling tired and weak.
Maya comes back from school. Mommy is already back from work. She has still not given any food to Ginger. Maya takes Ginger to the garden to play. Ginger does not want to play. He wants to eat food. Ginger sees a mouse. He wants to eat the mouse. The mouse runs out of the garden gate. Ginger too runs out of the gate. Ginger does not come back.